Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of my Arsenal Career Mode. And in this video here, we've got three very huge games. We're top of the league at the moment, you can see in the bottom right corner, and we have two games advantage ahead of Chelsea and one game advantage ahead of City and Manchester United. So we're definitely in a very good position right now. And if we can grab some very nice wins, some nice score lines like you're going to see here against Sunderland, then we will be in pole position going into the last few games, which is absolutely what I want. Seeing as I haven't had to focus on the Capital One Cup or, you know, Champions League or anything like that, it's been a relatively easy season for me to just focus on the Premier League. And you can see we are absolutely destroying Sunderland here. Insigne, Yilmaz, Cazorla, Ramsey, Insigne with a double actually, and that made it 5-0. And look at that, a 5-0 victory at home against Sunderland. I thought I would sim that match because I wanted to get four games done basically in this episode, so do forgive me. But then this popped up. Look at that, a Belgium offer. Now, I'll be honest with you guys, I've never really been into the whole international management in career mode, but this time I'm going to go ahead and accept this Belgium offer. However, if you're not interested in seeing the games, let me know in the comments below because I'll just simply sim them or, you know, get rid of them and not show you. But I accepted it because, you know what, if you guys want to see, you know, like a Belgium World Cup series, you know, that's what I'll be doing, playing them in the World Cup in the summer, then let me know because that's exactly what I could do. So don't forget to leave a comment, guys. Belgium gameplay or Belgium matches, I should say, yes or no. But now we go into one of the biggest matches of the season so far, and that is against Chelsea at Stamford Bridge. Arsenal have tended to do kind of well there recently. I remember Walcott scoring a pretty magical goal against Chelsea in recent years, so I'm hoping I can replicate that. Unfortunately, it's not sunny. We're playing in the rain. It looks horrible, but Stamford Bridge is one of those stadiums. You look at it, you do think, wow, that is a good-looking stadium. What I do like about it is how blue it is. Obviously, Chelsea are blue, and the whole stadium is blue. I think more stadiums should do that. There are stadiums out there that literally don't reflect the team colours or anything like that at all. And it's like the Emirates as well. It's very red when you get inside there, all the seats and stuff. So that's always nice to see. It's a nice atmosphere before the fans have even got in. But here you can see we're starting off very strongly here. In the fourth minute, Ozil gets a chance there. Cannot score it though. Ozil is in a bit of dip of form at the moment. He's unable to really finish some goals. So hopefully we'll get some with him in the next few matches. Yilmaz has a great shot and boom. Guess who it is? Ozil scores a very nice goal, and that is his eighth of the season. So not too bad record there. And I knew that was coming up, so I thought I'd confuse you a little bit. There you go with Ozil in the perfect attacking position possible. And it's a really simple finish. And Chelsea are 1-0 down in the first half. It's not going so well. And to be honest, I couldn't believe how easy I was finding this match. I was very comfortable. Chelsea weren't really doing too much. They had the odd chance with Demba Ba, but nothing worth showing you guys. Lovely little pass from Ozil to Gibbs there, into Yilmaz. And look at this goal. Oh, that touch. That touch was insane. And I said to you, I feel really comfortable in this game. And that's my 17th goal with Yilmaz in all competitions. Look at the way he scores this. Kind of like opens up his body and side foots it in. It's a really nice new animation that EA have put into the game. So now we're going to go into the second half, literally at the end of the match here. I kind of defended. I sat back throughout the rest of the match since going 2-0 up. And not much really happened, but I played a really nice ball into Insigne there. And it's in over to the box, but we couldn't grab that header. We couldn't grab the header. I do think the patch is working, guys. I'm certainly not scoring as many headers. Let me know if you feel the same. But there we go, guys. We get a 2-0 victory at Chelsea. That is one of the biggest results of the season so far. We get our own back because Chelsea knocked us out of the Capital One Cup, of course. And then I got an email asking me to put my selection to the national team up. And I tell you what, this Belgium team is very strong. We've got a few players here and there where, you know, I know of, like this Van Damme guy, a very strong left back. But there's a few players that really I don't see using too much. So I'm thinking formation-wise, if I am to play Belgium and show you guys the results and things like that, I'm thinking a 3-5-2 and the back three being Kompany, Vermaelen and Vertonghen. That is a very, very strong back three. And then you've got players like Hazard and you've got Witzel, Fellaini, Nainggolan, loads of so many great players. And obviously Lukaku and Benteke up front. I mean, just imagine that. It's absolutely insane. And Junior Malanda, by the way, I just highlighted him there. He is one of the fastest growing players in career mode. So I might actually do another video soon, seeing as, you know, we're starting to get into this career mode this year. We're starting to find out which players grow fast or not. Maybe I could do a video after you guys help me out with some players that you've seen growing fast, so we can put together a list of players that seem to do grow very quick. Obviously, we've got Bakalli in the side as well, so that's an interesting prospect to actually play around with Bakalli. I wouldn't mind doing like a review on Bakalli, seeing he is basically this year's star player in career mode. So let me know what you think about that one as well. But anyway, we move into another key game here. So we've had Chelsea and now Manchester City coming up. And after this, we have Everton. So it really is a tough few fixtures, this. And hopefully we're going to get all the 3 points every single game. But the game against City is probably the most important here because they are right behind us in the league. And if we win this match, we are going to make a nice gap because we've beaten Chelsea, so they've stayed on the same points and we've progressed. If we can do the same with City, I think we can safely say I'm guaranteed a top two spot at the end of the season, which is, you know, absolutely fantastic. And what I will say, guys, is I think I've made it into the Champions League already. I don't think I'm going to drop below top four, so that's great news, and it means we'll be in the Champions League next season. But against City, it's always a tough match, and straight away in this game, Yaya Toure in the 9th minute, I couldn't even get the ball off them, smashes it across goal. Chesney had absolutely no chance, and it's a stunning goal. Yaya Toure, for me, one of the best players in this career mode, or best player in FIFA 14 in general. He's one of them. Such a strong player, but agile and powerful. He's got so much strength, and that shot there you saw, he's pretty accurate with his long shots as well. But Gundogan picks up the ball in the middle of the pitch here, going forward towards their goal. We're getting plenty of shots against City, but I cannot break through the defence until they make a massive mistake. And Ozil, with a very similar goal to the one before, a shot from Yilmaz gets deflected, and it's straight to Ozil. And one thing about Ozil, he's always in the right place at the right time. And I still, to this day, I recorded this gameplay yesterday, I have no idea how I scored that. It seems to just squeeze in underneath Joe Hart there. And that meant it was 1-1, and we could go into this second half knowing that a draw is okay. I will take a draw, but we get through on goal here with Ramsey. He's going to get tackled from Zabaleta, but for some reason, Joe Hart completely stops in his path. He would have stopped it, but Ramsey gets through on goal, and he actually scores it. I could not believe it. It's two very, very lucky goals against City. And to be honest, they were far better than I was in this match. I've still got no idea how I scored these two goals. I mean, Joe Hart there is made one of the biggest mistakes you can make as a goalkeeper, and that is changing your mind. If you're going to go out to the player, continue with it. Don't just stop. They brought on Guidetti, who obviously is quite a good player in career mode for, in terms of potential. He's quite a nice young striker and a very good finisher as well. He comes close with a shot there towards the end of the game. And Man City have a corner. Are they going to level it out? Are we going to drop points? Guidetti on the ball here. Turns the defence. He's going to smash it across to Chesney. He makes a great save. And then he is offside when he tries to put the ball in the net. So I got very, very lucky there. Look at the little corner of City fans. Isn't it cool? Little details like that. But that was it, guys. We whacked that one out for a goal kick. And that is the end of the game. So we actually got another 3 points against the top three side. And that means, like I said, guys, look at the league table. We've got a 4-point gap and 2 games in hand on Manchester City. So, guys, it's looking like we're in a very, very good position to actually win the league this season, which, although it may not be the most realistic thing in real life, I think certainly the squad in FIFA in general, the Arsenal squad, is actually very good this year around. And I think that's a good result. I think it's a very good result, finishing possibly in first in my first season. But we'll see how the last few games get on. Now we're going up against Everton, and you know, guys, I struggle against Everton. They're such a good side. And Morales there, within 33 minutes, absolutely destroys my defence. Mertesacker, you can really see his slow pace. He's like very, very, very slow. He's like a snail. And Morales is like the complete opposite. Very, very, very strong and fast. Well, not strong, but he seems to just never fall over. He's good. He's got good balance, that's the word. And yeah, very, very pacey and quick off the mark. And Mertesacker was lagging behind, and they were able to score. We almost got one back there with Ramsey having a shot outside the D, but that was unfortunate not to go in. It was a good save from Akinfeev. He's still at the club, and he's doing very well. He's an absolute monster in this game. But now we're going into the second half. We're into almost the 70th minute here, and Yilmaz makes a great turn inside of the defence there and smashes it across the goal, and that is now his 18th in the league. He is now top scorer, guys. That is right, Yilmaz. Probably the best signing I've made so far. He is an absolute mammal up front. He scores so many goals, important goals as well. And like I said, he's top scorer. And now we're going into the last few minutes of the game. Can we get a goal to win this match and get another 3 points? Let's see what happens here. They're going to clear it. Whoa! Massive mistake there from Everton. And Cazorla is in. I mean, that, I'm getting so, so lucky. Towards the start of the season, guys, I was getting a lot of draws where I was conceding in the last minute. And you know what? I think I deserve a bit of a break. And they made a huge mistake in their defence there. And I've scored a late, late goal with Cazorla there. It's a really nice, composed finish. And that meant we get another 3 points. So, guys, in the next episode, in the next few days, you will see us progressing to the end of the season here. And hopefully we can come in first. Thank you for watching. Please do leave a like. And I'll see you in the next episode.